Good afternoon, everyone. Today, I'm going to talk about my current research about glucose sensing and driven organic engine with the co-immobilized membrane for actuation by blood sugar and diabetes. And today's outlines are shown here. And first, let me talk about diabetes shortly. As you know, blood sugar is regulated by pancreas hormone, insulin, and glucagon. When blood sugar increases, it stimulates insulin secretion, and insulin reduces blood glucose. But if dysfunction of insulin secretion occurs, it can cause chronic high blood sugar that damages vessels and nerves and heart. So insulin must be delivered properly to keep blood sugar normal. On the other hand, there are many insulin delivery systems such as insulin pen, insulin pump, but those devices are still some shortage, such as battery and electricity dependent, and patients need to control the blood sugar many times a day. So we have been developing glucose sensing and glucose driven diabetes system based on chemo-mechanical energy conversion, which is no need electrical supply. So here, let me talk about our research background. So as you know, there are many ATP powered motor proteins and enzymes in humans. Besides those, there are some enzymes that can generate mechanical energy from chemical substance as a gas. For example, the enzyme catalase can generate mechanical energy from hydrogen peroxide by dissolving it, as shown here. So it was able to obtain mechanical energy from hydrogen peroxide depending on its concentration. So in similar way to this, it's thought that organic engine that can generate mechanical energy from glucose by using its oxidizing enzyme glucose oxidase, and the organic engine based diabetic system was able to develop. So this slide shows our research steps. First, organic engine and organic engine based diabetic system was developed, and then the organic engine was optimized to make it able to actuate by the glucose concentration close to blood sugar levels, and then improved organic engine based diabetic system was fabricated in the world wide. So first, let me explain about our organic engine. As you can see in here, glucose oxidase can consume oxygen and gas by oxidizing glucose. So first, we immobilize glucose oxidase on diabetes membrane by photocrosslink linkable resin TVSPQ by light exposure for 2 hours. And then we installed the glucose oxidase membrane between 2 cells, one for glucose injection, one for gas. So in evaluation experiment results, there were good correlation between pressure in upper cell and glucose concentration. So it means that the decompression in our organic engine was able to controlled by glucose concentration. So then we developed the drug release units, which is able to release drugs by decompression in the organic engine autonomously. So as you can see here, as you can see in the pictures, there were the release was confirmed when we used the the pigment instead of drug. And then we fabricated the autonomous drug-release system by connecting organic engine and drug-release unit, and evaluated it in closed-loop setting. And as a result, the glucose concentration in closed-loop was getting lower, and time between drug-release was getting lower in the universe. It means that feedback control of glucose concentration was able to in our organic engine-based drug-release system. But the glucose concentration was 100 millimol. It's about 10 times higher than normal blood sugar. So the decompression rate in the organic engine must be improved. So we try to improve the compression rate in our organic engine by increasing oxygen consumption. So as you can see here, pyranose oxidase and glucose oxidase and alcohol oxidase was evaluated for co-immobilization in the organic engine. And as a result, pyranose oxidase and glucose oxidase showed the highest oxygen consumption compared to other enzymes. So pyranose oxidase and glucose oxidase was chosen for further experiments. And the optimum units of POX and GOD and its decompression rate was evaluated, and as shown in this table, the decompression rate in organic engine with co-immobilized membrane of POX and GOD showed 2.3 times higher decompression rate compared to organic engine with GOD alone. And also we evaluated the target decompression rate, and the target decompression rate means it's the decompression is needed for actuated drug release system. So as shown in the table, an improved organic engine, the target decompression rate was obtained in improved organic engine with 10 millimol glucose concentration. It's very close to human blood sugar data. And last, we fabricated the autonomous drug-release system by improved organic engine and drug-release system. So, as a result, as you can see in this movie, there were intermittent pressure release, and in the same time, drug-release was obtained. And also we evaluated in closed loop setting by using hexokinase. Hexokinase reduces glucose concentration, and in experiment, the mixed solution of glucose and ATP and magnesium chloride was circulated by a peristaltic pump and loop, and pressure inside the system was measured by differential pressure sensor, and the solution of inside the loop was sampled each 20 minutes to monitor glucose concentration. As a result, also the glucose concentration was getting lower and autonomously, and interval between drug release was getting longer in inverse. It means that autonomous glucose concentration was able to control autonomously in our drug release system in closed loop setting as well. Also, at this time, this glucose concentration 25 millimoles is very close to blood sugar level. So In conclusion, organic engine based autonomous derivative system was developed, and then organic engine was improved, and finally improved organic engine based derivative system was able to actuate the 25 millimole glucose, which lowers the blood sugar level. In the future, our system will be optimized a bit more. Thank you for your attention.